We're playing a little game called Own It, inspired by new Mets owner, Steve Cohen, who had a, what's that? What happens when your ears turn up a little bit? He had an ear turning up quote.
Yeah, man. Shout out to Bobby Axelrod. I mean, Steve Cohen, my fault. If I don't win a World Series in the next 3 to 5 years, I'd like to make it sooner. I would consider that slightly disappointing. Now, Steve Cohen said that yesterday in his introductory press conference owning the New York Mets. And he's got Mets fans on a natural high this week. If you've talked to anybody who's a Mets fan, they've been floating on air. They're excited. There's an excitement that comes with a new ownership group, right? Especially in baseball when there's no salary cap, right? The imagination can run wild. You know, we've seen it with the Dodgers. We've seen it with the Yankees. We've seen it with so many other teams. But now we're going to try a new segment called Own It, right, Monica? We're talking about teams, our favorite teams, and what we would do if we were Bobby Axelrod in the flesh. I mean, Steve Cohen owning our favorite sports team. So, Monica, do you want to kick that off?
Okay, yeah. So, really quick, before we jump to that, do you think if Cohen comes in a year earlier, is there a world in which Mookie Betts was a Met this past year?
Well, I mean, you look at him and you still can't believe that the Red Sox, with all the money that they got, let a guy that good go. I think there definitely is a world where Mookie Betts comes to the New York Mets, but I think he's making great do in Los Angeles, and I think he's got a ring to show for it.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Yeah, the hardware definitely is there. It's proof in the pudding. Okay, so the game. Own it. Pick a team. We're the owner. First three things that you would do. Kaz, you're up.
First thing I'm doing, I'm a New York Jets fan through and through, and obviously they need their own home. I don't care if you call it MetLife Stadium, I don't care what you call it. The Jets need their own place to call home. So that's the first thing I'm doing if I own the Jets. Second thing I'm doing, I'm taking Adam Gase, right? I'm calling NASA up, I'm strapping him to a rocket, and I'm launching him into outer space and say, thanks for nothing, buddy. Appreciate you coming here. We'll see you when we see you. So he'd be out of here. And thirdly, I would bring back my all-time favorite New York Jets head coach, Herm Edwards. I'd put him in the front office because that dude knows how to motivate. He knows how to inspire. He's a player's coach. And because you play to win the game. Hello?
Hello? You know Herm is a little busy these days, though.
Arizona State, listen, the checks I'd be cutting for the New York Jets, he'd say, thank you, Arizona State, appreciate you, but I'm going to go take this cushy front office job and work with Kaz.
Okay, fair enough. All right, so I am going to stick with football and go to my beloved home team, the Washington football team. My first order of business is that we are going to get every resource we have dedicated to finding us a quarterback, right? I understand that we might not have a high enough draft pick in this particular draft to get someone good, so we may have to go with a veteran that we trust this offseason, but I need someone who is vetted. There's a world in which Cam Newton comes to mind, reuniting with Ron Rivera, but Cam also needs to play better than he's played as of late. Mm-hmm. All right, so quarterback is top, like, first thing on the business. I also, order of business number two, I'm changing team to club, and I'm just going to roll with it. We're the Washington football club, European soccer.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah. Like,
I'm just going to go with it. Because you know what was corny until they started winning? A Seahawk was corny until they won a Super Bowl. So the Washington football club, I don't care. Let's just be better, and then it won't matter. And you know how we get better, Kaz? My third order of business?
What's up?
I am hiring Louis Riddick as my general manager, run the whole shebang. He knows he's got great relationships in the league. He knows the game like the back of his hand. He has great relationships with current players, not just front office folks. I know I mentioned great relationships twice. And he's brilliant and deserves a chance to run my organization.
Super charismatic as well.
To the baby.
Super charismatic. It's like, it's almost a shame that a team hasn't called him to run a franchise at this point, man. Like, that dude is extremely talented, and I'd love to see him run that team. Also, if I was running the Redskins with you, I would hire somebody.
Football Club.
I'm sorry. Ooh, my gosh. We'll edit that out. The Washington Football Club, if I was owning that, I would hire somebody to personally give Dwayne Haskins a hug every time because he just got such a raw deal. Such a raw deal, Dwayne, man. He'll be all right. He got that Josh Rosen scrub, man. It's rough.
It's tough what has happened to Dwayne. However, he's young, still talented, has an upside if he can land in the right place or the organization can figure out a way to groom him to be better. But we're not going to get stuck there. We're leaving our imaginary world as owners in which we have endless pockets where we could do so many other things if we can afford to own football teams. But anyway, we're going back to reality. Anthony Carter is coming through. We're going to talk NHL, big picture things, some of the really cool things that he's working on alongside of the league and some passion projects. So stick around. More MSG AM with the great Anthony Carter is up next.
Let's get it.